All of the pieces that I'm playing today are from the seasons of the liturgical church. On our hymn boards on both sides, if you want to follow along with the hymn, the text, so that you understand the concept of the hymns that are being played, I think it'll add to the recital and understand each season as it comes. I'm very thankful that you came out on a Saturday afternoon. Thank you for traveling from the distances that you did. And we're going to get started. Father Tom's going to come down. He's recording today, and he's going to ask a blessing on our service, even though it's an out-of-church service. It's all the seasons of our church year. Father Tom.
Waiting for this day for a long time. We're really excited to host Sharon's recital, and what better way to begin than with a word of prayer. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, we thank you for the gift of time and of season as they change. You are at work in different ways, but always present. And we thank you for the ways that this recital brings our attention to the seasons of the year, the ways that we celebrate your action, your movement in this world and in our lives. And we ask your blessing over this moment right now, that it indeed would be a blessing to each and every one of us as we enjoy the gift of praise through music. It's in Jesus' name we pray, and in the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen.
next piece is a variation of Pure Nobis, and it has 9 variations. And it's interesting because the composer loves to teach children. He's a professor of music, and he grew up in choir schools. He was born in Wisconsin, and his goal in sixth grade was to become a music teacher because he loves to teach children. Now, the interesting thing about this piece is that the first variation is a flute. It's a simple melody line. Just the first verse. The second verse, the second variation, is 2 parts. It's like watching him write with part writing skills and how the children learn. The children have these really, really high voices up in the bell range, like up above high C sometimes. And this piece is written starting out just like he's teaching children to sing. It doesn't end like that, it's much louder than that, but the first couple of variations are just amazing how he takes his skill of writing music, he's written much, and teaches it through the way he has taught children. So this is probably one of my favorite pieces in this series.
Thank you.
next piece I'm going to play for you has an interesting history for me. I was the organist and choir master at the base in 2004, 2002, you know, for quite a few years and way back before when we were there in the 90s. And this particular piece has these falling melody lines. And it's almost like crying. You can almost hear the bass lines going, it leaps from one and falls. The treble line leaps and falls and falls and falls. And when I was at the bass, we went through a very, very difficult time because we were losing a lot of servicemen. And I happened to, because I was at the chapel, I was the organist for every single chaplain on that base. So every time a battalion or unit had somebody that had passed, I ended up serving in that capacity. And so it was not just once a month, it was like 3-4 times a week that I would be doing memorial services. And so when this piece came along, it just reminded me of the heaviness of that time period, the heaviness of the cross. And so this piece is very special to me too. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming today. It's been a long time coming, and I'm so thankful for you. You've been in my life. You've been by my side. You've sung with me. We've played music together. We've had readings together. Wonderful artwork and talented people, musicians, faithful supporters, helpers in so many different ways, and family alongside. I'm so thankful for all of you. There is a reception through this door. I think the other one's locked, or you can unlock that one. And that will be in Mosley Hall. Please join us. Join me for this reception. And thank you for coming today. Love you.